This is the story of Winnie the Pooh and the Blustery Day. You can read along with me in your book. You will know it is time to turn the page when you hear the chimes ring like this. Let's begin now. Winnie the Pooh, or Pooh for short, lived with his friends in the 100-acre wood. One very blustery day, when the winds decided to stir things up, Pooh went to visit his thinking spot. As Pooh sat there, trying hard to think of something, up popped his friend Gopher.
Hey, Pooh, if I were you, I'd think about skedaddling out of here. It's Wednesday, see?
Pooh thought that sounded like a lot of fun.
Then I think I shall wish everyone a happy Wednesday, and I will begin with my dear friend, Piglet.
The wind was blowing very hard as Pooh neared Piglet's house.
Happy Wednesday, Piglet. I see you're sweeping leaves.
Yes, Pooh, but it's hard. This is a very unfriendly wind.
Just then, a big gust blew Piglet up into the air. Pooh watched in surprise.
Where are you going, Piglet?
I don't know, Pooh. Oh, dear.
Pooh tried to help, but when he grabbed Piglet's sweater, it began to unravel.
Oh!
Piglet flew like a kite over the countryside, with Pooh dragging behind.
Oh, Piglet!
The two went right through Eeyore's house and Rabbit's carrot patch.
Oh! Oh.
Then with the blusteriest, gustiest gust of all, Piglet and Pooh were blown right up to Owl's house in a tall tree.
Pooh, Piglet, oh, this is a special treat. I so rarely get visitors up here. Do come in.
Owl opened his window and in blew Pooh and Piglet. The wind blew harder and harder, until finally Owl's tree, along with his house, crashed to the ground. Everyone from the 100-acre wood came to help Owl. But only gloomy old Eeyore seemed to know what to do.
If you ask me, and nobody has, I say when a house looks like that, it's time to find another one. A thankless job, but I'll find a new one for 'em.
And off he plodded. Finally, the blustery day turned into a blustery night. To Pooh, it was an uncomfortable night, full of uncomfortable noises. And one of the noises was a sound he had never heard before. Pooh got up and went to his door to investigate.
Hello out there. Oh, I hope nobody answers.
Just then, a funny-looking animal bounced into the room.
Hi, I'm Tigger, T-I-double-G-R.
Pooh put down his pop gun.
You scared me.
Sure I did. Everyone's scared of Tiggers.
Well, what's a Tigger?
Oh, glad you brought that up, chum.
Then Tigger bounced around the room to show Pooh what a Tigger was. Tigger stopped bouncing.
Did I say I was hungry?
Not for honey, I hope.
Yuck! Tiggers don't like that icky, sticky stuff. Well, I better be bouncing along. TGFN, ta-ta for now.
The wind continued to blow. There was a clap of thunder and it began to rain. And it rained, and it rained, and it rained. By morning, the 100-acre wood was flooded. Pooh tried to rescue his honey by eating it all for breakfast. He was upside down, licking the bottom of the last pot, when the water floated him right out his front door. At Piglet's house, the water was coming in through the window. He wrote a message and put it into a bottle. The message read, "Help, Piglet, me." The bottle floated out of his house and out of sight. Christopher Robin lived high on a hill where the water couldn't reach, so that was where everyone from the 100-acre wood gathered. Before long, Christopher Robin discovered Piglet's bottle and read the message.
Owl, fly over to Piglet's house and tell him we'll plan a rescue.
As Owl flew over the flood, he spotted two tiny objects below. One was Piglet, standing on a chair, and the other was Pooh, still upside down in his honey pot. Owl called down to them and told them of the rescue.
Be brave, little Piglet.
Thank you, Owl. But it's awfully hard to be brave when you're such a small animal.
Pooh and Piglet eventually floated to the very spot where Christopher Robin was waiting.
Pooh, you rescued Piglet. That was a very brave thing to do. You're a hero.
I am?
Yes, and so I shall give you a hero party.
Just as the hero party began, Eeyore arrived with news.
I found a house for Owl. If you want to follow me, I'll show it to you.
Eeyore led them through the woods and, to everyone's surprise, stopped in front of Piglet's house.
This is it.
Pooh tried to convince Piglet to speak up.
No, Pooh. This house belongs to our good friend Owl. I shall live.
You shall live with me.
Pooh put his arm around his little friend. Christopher Robin was especially proud.
That was a very grand thing to do, Piglet, giving your house to Owl.
And so the one hero party became a two-hero party. Pooh was a hero for saving Piglet's life, and Piglet was a hero for giving Owl his grand home in the beech tree.
Hip, hip, hooray!
For the Piglet.
And the Pooh.
We never will forget our hero of the wet, our quick-thinking, unsinking Pooh Bear. And Piglet, who indeed helped out a friend in need. Truly they're the heroes of the day. So we say hip, hip, hooray for the Piglet and the Pooh. Piglet and Pooh, we salute you for deeds of bravery and generosity.